Hey everyone, welcome to 601 Travels. We already told you why Jackson is a great place in another video, but in this one, we're going to tell you why you should think twice about settling down here and calling it home. Before we get started, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button to join our travel community. We do top 10s just like this one, plus city tours and highway drives. Make sure you smash that notification bell so you don't miss a future upload. Here's our list of top 10 reasons you should not move to Jackson, Mississippi. Number 10, potholes. To say that Jackson has bad roads is an understatement. The roads there, especially in particular neighborhoods, are horrific. The potholes are more like craters and are very deep. If you accidentally drive into one, your vehicle will become disabled. At the very least, it'll cause severe damage to your suspension, pop your tires, and bend your rims. And people around here love their rims. You may hit mailboxes or family pets while swerving to avoid the potholes in Jackson. It forces you to go slow and keep your eyes on the road. The last thing you want to do is to drive into a sinkhole. Number 9, dangerous. The crime in Jackson is no joke. It's what makes people not want to visit there, let alone move there. It's also what is making longtime residents flee the city the second they can. It is just downright dangerous, no matter what time of day or night you go there. Jackson's crime rates are 113% higher than the national average. 113%! That's a lot of percent. Violent crimes specifically are 98% higher than the national average. If you're in the city, you have a 1 in 19 chance of becoming the victim of a crime. Doing things like going grocery shopping or the Dollar General are now considered a hazardous event. Just check out a Jackson News website to read the headlines for yourself. There are daily shootings and crimes that you would expect to see in bigger cities like Chicago or St. Louis, but it's right there in Jackson, Mississippi. Number 8, abandoned houses. Pride of ownership, property values, what's that? Now, okay, some people take care of their homes in Jackson and it shows. It's nice to see a house with cut grass, one color, all the windows, and maybe only one broken down car in the driveway. But there are a ton of abandoned houses here. Roughly 4,000, according to the useless Jackson City officials. Not empty houses waiting to be purchased for a loving family to move into. These are vandalized, half burnt down, go in to do drugs and dump bodies kind of houses, and the city doesn't do anything about it. They just leave them to depreciate home values, create hazards for people walking in the neighborhood, and are targets for graffiti and vandalism. Number 7, homeless people. Unfortunately, because of the lack of opportunities, support, and because some people just have no drive to do anything more than stand on a street corner or outside the convenience store, there is a large homeless population. Almost 2,000 people right in the city. While most keep to themselves, other than when they're panhandling, you'll come across those that are aggressive and will make you feel uncomfortable, even threatened. Like when you order a McDonald's, they'll be standing at the order thing when you pull up with a sign asking for money. Just makes a lot of areas of the city a bit hostile, and while it's horrible these people are homeless, a small portion of them makes the whole group something a lot of people try to stay away from. Number 6. Entertain what? It's not safe to go to a club, the state fair, or any other social affairs in Jackson due to its gang presence. Residents always travel out of the city to do things for entertainment, from concerts to just having a nice dinner. One could argue Fondren is a fun, hip place in Jackson, but it's still Jackson. You know that whole put lipstick on a pig thing? There's a lot of opportunities for violence because of how bad the crime is in Jackson. If you enjoy going to the concerts and not feeling like you might be a victim of a violent crime or murdered, you will find yourself going to places like Brandon or South Haven to see performers and feeling a lot safer doing so. Number 5, the job market sucks. The average income for an individual in Jackson is just over $19,000. That's 34% lower than the national average. And the unemployment rate is 7.9%. What's even worse is that the poverty levels is over 30%. Unless you're planning on trying to get a job with the state of Mississippi or at the college, your employment prospects are going to be very limited. There aren't a lot of job opportunities here. Many people who do work don't even work in the city, but rather in outlying communities where there are jobs worth traveling to. If you're even considering moving to Jackson, make sure you've got contractual work lined up before you go, because you shouldn't plan on just finding something. Number 4. On a volcano. You'd never think there was a volcano in Jackson, but there is. Right underneath the Mississippi Coliseum is the Jackson Volcano. It is an extinct volcano, but it's still there, 2,900 feet below the city, waiting for the opportunity to reclaim the nature that was taken from it. The rim of the volcano is almost a half mile wide and extends well into the city. Now, I'm not an expert on volcanoes by any means, and I don't know if they can reactivate themselves, but I have watched Dante's Peak a few times, and I know one thing. Besides not letting grandma out of the canoe, if there's a volcano nearby, expect and plan for it to erupt. Number 3. Tornadoes. Mississippi as a whole is very much prone to getting tornadoes. So much, in fact, that it gets more tornadoes per year than other states you'd associate them with, like Iowa or Oklahoma. Jackson, being in the somewhat center of the state, seems to always get very violent storm squalls that produce large and long-tracked tornadoes. Mississippi had close to 400 tornadoes over the last 4 years, most of them being in the central and northern part of the state. Living in Jackson, you're not only taking your life into your hands by going to the grocery store because of the crime, you now have to worry about the weather. Number 2. Segregation. According to Apartments.com, Jackson, Mississippi is still one of the most segregated cities in the United States. The population consists of 82% black, 16% white, and almost 1% of two or more races, and 3% of other. The report shows that there are clearly defined areas in the city where each ethnicity lives. Driving around the city, you can clearly see that as well. It's the type of city where if you end up in the wrong neighborhood, you'll know it because of the looks you get and how you're treated. There are a lot of good people left in Jackson, but segregation is still a real and prevalent problem. Number 1. Schools suck. You'd think with over 60 public schools in Jackson, they might have some kind of system for success, but they don't. The standardized test scores for the city are 63% lower than the national average. Only 79% of the residents there completed high school. Why? Maybe because the school system there isn't doing enough to provide safety or giving the time to the students it's teaching. If you have kids, there are plenty of other reasons not to move to Jackson, but this one should stand out to you. There is no reason the scores should be that low anywhere. Alright everyone, that'll do it for today's video. Do you live in or love Jackson? Maybe you hate it. While you're here, please don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. That makes us really happy. Thank you so much for watching. Bye y'all!